Hi everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Aisha speaking. Today I'll be talking about how I personally went from 48th percentile to 90th percentile on my MCARS. And I want to share with you tips and tricks that worked for me so that you can also improve in this really annoying section. So a bit about myself, I'm from Toronto, Canada, and I wrote the MCAT twice. Once in 2018 summer and once in 2019 summer. And the first time I wrote it, I actually did pretty well on my science sections. So that included biology, chemistry, psych, and sociology. But when I saw my MCAT score for CARS, 48th percentile, I was very disappointed and a bit nervous because, you know, Canada especially places overall, but some schools, they place more emphasis on this particular section. So for instance, McMaster University has only been looking at this one section, and it's 33% of, you know, your whole entire score. So suffice to say, it was very important for me to do well in this section. And so I thought, you know what, I'm going to rewrite this, and I'm going to make sure that I really improved my score. Now, you know, when I rewrote when I started studying for the rewrite, I really was nervous and I really wanted to make sure that I did everything to improve my score. And, you know, it looks really bad to the admission committee if you rewrite and you end up getting the same or lower score, because you want to show an upward projection in your application, whether that's your grades or your test scores. And so I really sat down and I thought about, what did I do wrong the first time around? And a lot of students find this particular section very challenging because it's not like the other sections. You don't need a prerequisite background information knowledge to do well on this test. So you can't study for it like you studied bio or chem. You can't read a textbook. You can't make flashcards. So you need practice. But a lot of people are confused, like, what do I use to practice? How do I practice? Do I just do practice passages and hope for the best? I mean, that's what I did the first time around, and clearly that didn't work. So I came up with a strategy that really helped me improve my critical thinking skills. And intuitively, I knew what it was, but later on, I found out there's actually a name for this technique, and that's called a blind review. Now, I'm gonna tell you what I did, and just as a disclaimer, this worked for me. It might not work for you. The key is, if you're studying for the MCAT alone, which a lot of people are, it's figuring out what works for you and what doesn't. So a lot of it is active studying. So what I did was, first of all, I did consistent practice. Almost every day around the same time, I did practice passages, and I made sure that they were under timed conditions. And so, you know, under non-COVID conditions, we had 10 passages and 90 minutes. So, or I'm mixing it up, but I know that it's 10 minutes per passage. So when I did these practice passages, I made sure to only allot 10 minutes per passage. So I did practice for 30 minutes under test conditions. So I didn't have like my phone on. I didn't take random breaks in the middle. I made sure that I did it under that allotted time, and I had no outside distractions, or even I didn't have the access to the answer key. So I did consistent timed practice under test conditions. Now, the next thing that I did was actually more important than the practice. So I took a break, let's say 5-10 minutes. I walked around, I checked my phone, whatever, and then I went back to it. Now, this is where the blind review comes into light. So what I did was, I did not check what I got wrong and what I got right, okay? I didn't check the answer key. I didn't even know how much I got right or wrong. But what I did was, I went back to the passage and I read it again, but now under non-timed condition. Now, the thing about CARS that I realized after spending like almost 2 summers like studying for it, is that for CARS, it's very important to know the main idea. You should be able to read the passage and provide a spark note summary to someone who doesn't even know the subject matter. And so in order to get into that habit of it, what I did was I like writing things down. So what I did, I opened a Google document and I went and read the passage. And because I found it intimidating to just like read it all at once and then do a summary, I built up that habit by reading paragraph by paragraph and then writing a sentence summarizing what the author was talking about. You know, oh, this paragraph, it's about the author saying, for example, war sucks, or like whatever, like in very simple terms, just to assess my comprehension. I did it for all the paragraphs, and at the end I again wrote the main idea. So a tip is for CARS, there's gonna be a lot of extraneous information. The author can rant on about things that don't even matter. Your job is to like look through that passage and be like, okay, whatever, like you can, you know, talk on and on about XYZ, but what is the main idea? And I wrote it down so that I, you know, writing it down helps solidify the concepts, make it concrete. Because what I realized in my first attempt, I wouldn't write things down. I would do it in my head like, oh yeah, that's what I thought. But you know, there's no way of verifying it, you know? It's about catching yourself thinking the wrong things. It's about mapping down your progress. So after reading it, I went down to the questions. Again, I don't know whether I got it right, wrong, what was I thinking? So then I read the question again and I went through each of the choices and I basically defended it, whether A is correct or B is correct, whatever. And I said, this is correct because XYZ. And there were times where I completely guessed the answer choice. That's fine. Even if you guess, write it down like, oh, I really did not understand this. I guessed. Write it down because it's going to make you accountable to your mistakes instead of just doing it in the air and like just moving on, you know? And after I have gone through everything, I then check the answer explanation and I try to see whether my logic was aligning with the test prep company's logic. And doing this, I'm telling you, really improved my logic and thinking, and it made me like see the patterns and the way they asked the questions. Because beforehand, I really didn't know what I was thinking during the test. I picked questions randomly. Maybe I did have some kind of reasoning, but I didn't really know in concrete terms what I was thinking. And in terms of the explanations making sense, sometimes the logic that you used and the test prep company's logic might not align. And I would say that's okay if it's non-AAMC material, because, you know, AAMC is actually making the test, so you need to make sure you understand their reasoning and logic. But let's say you're using Khan Academy or Princeton Review. If it doesn't make sense, you know, that is fine, but make sure that your logic and reasoning aligns with the AAMC, because they're the ones making the test, and you want to make sure, you want to get into their mindset and see how do they ask questions and how do they answer questions. And sometimes the explanations might not be sufficient, especially with AAMC test material. So what I would do is I would go online to either Reddit or MCAT or even Google and see if there's anyone else with the same question, and then you can have like discussions about that. I will talk about the resources that I use, the pros and cons for it, in another video, but this blind review method really changed the game for me, because I was no longer relying on just like, you know, wishy-washy thing and just like practicing without actually being aware of my weaknesses and strengths. After doing this, I started noticing patterns. I started noticing the patterns in the types of questions people or the test prep companies asked. I started noticing common mistakes that I personally did and avoiding that in the future. And so what I did after the Google Doc, you know, had all the stuff, I can link it down below. I actually started tracking my performance. So every day I made a Google sheet and I basically wrote down the questions I did, what was my score, what was my mood, did I have an exceptionally good day? Did I have an exceptionally bad day? Why was it? Blah, blah, blah. And then I also, in a huge document, started writing down common patterns that I saw on MCAT CARS, how to approach them, and also the vocabulary. Now, MCAT CARS, you don't really need to know complicated words, but I found it beneficial for me to just like expand my vocabulary and write down any words that I saw but didn't know the meaning to, because there were times in MCAT CARS where they would actually have like a weird word that's not commonly used, and they would actually ask you to not define it but define it within the context of the passage. And one of the biggest things I learned is don't use outside knowledge. Everything that you need to know is in the passage. And anytime, you know, I started, you know, using my background information, that's when I got the question wrong, because that's a common mistake. So just to recap, consistent, timed practice under test conditions and blind review. Why is it blind? Because you do not know the mark that you have, the answer explanations, and it forces you to read the passage and use logic and reasoning to reach the answer rather than making random guesses. And honestly, like, sometimes it was really difficult to get like 2 out of 10 or whatever. It really like, it put me accountable for my thinking. And you know, when you're self-studying for the MCAT, you have to be your own teacher. You have to do your own self-assessments. And that was what I was missing on my first try, that sense of accountability and, you know, tracking my progress. Because again, it's such a difficult test. But again, I feel like people can definitely improve if they put their mind to it. And, you know, I think one of the biggest things that helped me improve and do well on the second try is believing in myself and knowing that I'm putting in my 100% effort. And that's all that matters at the end of the day. And so, you know, I'm going to do more parts on this, but this is what really helped me go from 48th percentile to 90th percentile, increasing my chances of admission. And you know, thank you so much for watching. If you all have tips and tricks for, you know, for this section and for other sections, please do leave a comment below. Please subscribe, like this video. I hope you found this helpful. I'm definitely going to be making more videos on this subject matter, especially the resources that I use, and even maybe, you know, the patterns and question types that I saw and how to approach them. So if you would like to see a video on these topics, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching.